fingers on the thumb side of the wrist. Start counting with zero. Get ready and begin. Stop. All right, that is your baseline. You want to see the numbers go up. Not too high. Hopefully it won't be too bad to this time because, again, the heat and humidity, we're going to try to keep the workouts a little on the lighter side. Try to. Arms overhead, not as much if you can help it. Keep them down if you're feeling like you're working too hard. All right, so let's begin with Valkyrie time. And breathe and march.
Bend knees
just to get worked out. Last four. and take it. 1, 2, 3. Out, out. Starts left. Get your heart rate. Get ready and begin. Stop. All right, so that 10 second count should be a little higher. You should be kind of up in your zone, but on the lower side of things. Now we're starting with happy. Happy is the one that we go around the block, wall to wall to wall, and we start with out, out, in. Four of those, and then four marches to the next wall, out, out, in. Four times, four marches to the next wall, all the way around. We have the cross point series. Forward, 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 side cross. And then we have the happy, which is a rock step, high lift, rock step, 1, 2, 3, and then rock step, high lift, rock step, 1, 2, 3. And then that happens, and we just keep repeating all those elements. Let's do it. Because when you Here we go. Now on your toes. And again, if you're too high already, too hot, you can still press forward and push back. So how we did it in warm up, slow push back. You can do both arms forward. Should be up in your zone, and again, keeping it there, but try not to work at the high end of your zone today. Because, well, I'm saying today because right now it's super hot and humid. You're going to be doing this on a week that might not be that bad, but Monday is. So today, the day you're, if you're watching it, the day it airs, it's still going to be hot and humid. Always take care. Drink plenty of water, and let's go on to the next song. So, whatever space you have, you're going to go heel, 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 heel. And then kind of press, 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 press. Heel, 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 heel. And then get ready for the swoop. You can swoop at a middle level, not overhead.
Thank you.
the other direction. Out. Sitting nice and tall in your chair. Forward lean. And make sure that your right cheek, rotating left, your right cheek should stay down on the chair. That means you may have to come up a little higher, but you'll get a better stretch. And come back up and cross. Sit tall. Slide your hip back and relax. Slide back. Hold. Relax. Slide back. Hold. Relax. And other side. Sitting tall. Very straight spine. Press forward.
Stop your
Hold it. And now, the angle.
Go home to your wife and your family. Sit down by the fireside bright. I read the night.
And then, up, over. Long spine forward. Stretch 5, 6, 7, 8. Come back up and bend the knee. And then turn and slide down. And again, you want to keep, now it's your left sit bone on the chair. Don't rock up off of that sit bone just to get further back. Over, sit tall, and it's not open. It's bring it up in it as much as you can and hold it there. And then pull that hip toward the back of the chair and release it. Back. And release it. And last time, pull back.
Georgia.
And release.
Georgia.
Feet wide. Fingers in, elbows out, and we're going to take shoulder to opposite knee.
Just an old sweet song.
And make sure you're not hiking your shoulders up. You're pushing down and across. And then one more on each side. So where you should be feeling the stretch is right here. Chest perhaps. Maybe some middle to low back. Up, down, that way. It's a diagonal motion. come back. Very good. Let's do some finger curls and curl your toes up and stretch and curl. Stretch and curl. So just really focus on getting your fingers to bend, not covering the palm up. I'm not doing anything to my shoulders. Don't make them hunch up. Automatically, when you tilt your pelvis, I'm just being relaxed up here, but there is a sort of a scooping out, and your shoulders appear to be kind of going forward, but they're just going along for the ride. Now go from the center here, neutral spine, and arch the back. Imagine that your pelvis is a bowl of water. You're going to spill the water out of the front of the bowl and come back to neutral and spill water, come back to neutral, water. And where you should be feeling the work on that one is your back, your low back, your middle back. You're actually contracting those muscles to work. So now we're going to stretch them one more time, okay? So both actions are important. You want to be able to do both. Now send one hip forward and one hip back. We do this standing, and it feels totally different. We're going to do it sitting as well today, front to back, just to stretch that all out. Yeah, get that motion. Good. All right. And let's see, we have time for one more thing. other way. You do these in class and with a few other things too. You do a lot of things in class in person. Please consider joining us. There are two Get Fits, one at 9 and one at 10:30. So whichever time frame suits you best is the one you have some options. All right. So thank you for joining. Let's get a final heart rate. Two fingers, thumb side. If you take your pulse that you're carotid, make sure you're not back on the muscle. You're not going to feel it on the muscle, but next to your vocal cords, kind of that little spot down there, a little depression right there. And don't push hard, and don't push with both sides at the same time, all right? So two fingers. Remember to start counting the beats that you feel with 0. Get ready. And begin. Stop. Okay, so hopefully your number is back down to within 1 or 2 beats of your first number, or maybe it is all the way back down, maybe it's even less than. I hope you had a fun time, and I hope that you'll come and visit us in person very soon. Have a great week.